are yaks.
If you have like a funny thought or you have a relevant piece of news you want to share with your local community, that's what you can get.
24-year-old Tyler Droll and Brooks Buffington are the founders of Yik Yak. It's an app that's now reportedly valued at $400 million. The app, whose name was inspired by the classic 50s song,
Don't Talk Back,
lets you send anonymous messages and read chatter within a 1.5-mile radius. Users vote up comments they like and vote down ones they don't. Brooks and Tyler first worked on the app when they were in college.
We saw a problem on our campus where there was a select few like Twitter accounts, which kind of held the campus voice. We said, you know, everyone should be able to have this power. And so we kind of democratized it, gave it to everyone, and allowed the whole campus to connect.
Fast forward a year later, the app is exploding on college campuses across the country.
Basically, every campus in America.
At Vanderbilt University, someone, you know, posted something about his brother. He's getting a full body blood transfusion and posted on Yik Yak. 700 people showed up in the first hour to see if they were a match for this guy's brother.
That's the upside of what can be accomplished with an anonymous discussion forum like Yik Yak. The downside? Anonymity can lead to bullying or harassment. No username, no accountability.
How do you guys try to help with the cyberbullying problem?
We have filters running for names, you know, for personal information, you know, just generally offensive things.
Early on, made a set of rules about no targeting people, no bullying, and we took the kind of daring step to enforce them strongly. We wanted good growth, not growth at all costs.
Yik Yak still had growing pains. One professor complained after discovering demeaning yaks during her lectures. Other students have cited online harassment. Just this month, a university official sent a letter to the company seeking identities of people inciting danger.
For the people that kind of are bullied on it or have been bullied, what is your responsibility, your kind of legal responsibility?
Yeah, I mean, there's federal laws in place that prevent, you know, sharing of private, you know, like user information. So that we're kind of limited in what we can do there. But in cases of like imminent threat or harm or something like that, we work with law enforcement to, you know, do what we can.
The founders say they're focused on expanding beyond the college audience and to people who are looking for a Facebook alternative.
I think like Facebook and some other apps where you have to keep up with this profile, it's very heavy, and Yik Yak's very lightweight. You can just talk. It's like real life.
Lori Siegel, CNN Money, Austin, Texas.